Hi everyone, I'm Avneesh Kumar. I have cleared Delhi Judicial Service and I have uploaded two videos previously. Many of you have asked questions and some people have asked small things. So I thought it be fitting that I should upload another video which may deal with your questions only. Because many times people ask the same question and then I have to either re-explain the whole thing, so you may watch the video to get some clarity on the issues. The first question which was asked by many of you was which book to refer in respective subjects. Well, again I would repeat my point that first of all you may take A K Jain's Kunji for every subject. It is very concise, very good. And secondly, after that you may have one standard book for those topics which are either absent in A K Jain or they are not properly explained. I refer to one standard book in every subject. For example, in constitutional law I refer to Pandey, IPC I refer to Pillai, both these books are very good. For contract I refer to Avtar Singh. You may take Avtar Singh's Mercantile Law, which contains contract and sale of goods and other small acts. PPI refer to Avtar Singh, did not find it very good, but again it may be enough for clearing the exam. CrPC I refer to Kelkar, for CPC I refer to Takwani. Evidence you may refer to Batuklal, I had Avtar Singh, that is also okay. For minor act I think Jains would be sufficient. For family law you refer to Paras Devan. I have put the links of these books below wherever I could find them. After that, for pre-exam, you may refer to at least one book which contains MCQ questions, because MCQ practice is very important for you people, otherwise you tend to forget small things. For MCQ practice, you may refer to first of all O P Tripathi, but it's not very exhaustive, only a few subjects are given, and then there is Universals MCQ by Vinay Kumar Gupta, I think. That is a very good book. It contains all the subjects, and there is also a larger volume for it, which would be very useful. It also contains theory. I have given the links below the video. After that, the question was that should you make notes or should you directly read from a book? In my opinion, it is better to make notes, and very small notes. Make every subject notes in less than 100 pages, so you may quickly revise the subject. Another question was that which coaching? Well, I took coaching from Rahul sir, and I found that Rahul sir and Srivastav sir both are very good teachers. They taught wonderfully. Just now I think Srivastav sir is no more teaching, but I think there are other teachers. So that was my coaching. I would certainly advise you to go for it. If you cannot find it, admission in it, then I think Ambition and T.R. Singh and Amit sir, they are all good teachers, as I heard from the review of my friends. Another question was how to improve English. Well, that's something I have said again and again, that start reading newspaper. When you read something, it improves your language. If your English is too weak, then start from Thakur. Thakur's book I found to be very useful because it is given in very simple terms. If you are somewhere at the middle level, then you can refer to Lucent or Bhardwaj or any other book, I think. Doesn't matter much actually. Again, another question was how to deal with practical questions. See, in practical questions, you don't have to write something very different. Your task is that firstly you find that which provision is applicable, and secondly then test it as per the ingredients of section. Suppose in the problem there is some theft, so you must apply the ingredients of theft, that is, was it a movable property, was it under possession of some person, and was there some movement of property. So in this way you must identify which section is applicable and then discuss the section along with the problem. That is the only thing you are required to do. Another question was, should we read case laws? Yes, definitely. How many case laws? See, there is no fixed number as such. I think you must read as many as you can And if your concept is clear, then one or two cases may be enough. If your concept is not clear, then maybe more cases. I would broadly say that in big subjects like CPC, CRPC, you may read 40-50 cases. In smaller subjects, you may read 30-40. In minor acts like sale of goods, you may read 10-12 cases. It all depends. But always remember that conceptual clarity is a must. So first, you go with the concept. Then, if you get time, then go for case notes. How to improve writing skills? Practice it. You must practice answer writing. When you do practice, slowly it would itself get improved. Because there is no magic wand for it. You know, if you want to take some book, I would advise you to take Shailendra Gill's book. I took his book on the mains papers of Haryana. It was good, although there are too many case laws. Then another question was, what book for essay and language? See, essay and language, I did not refer to any book, so I cannot suggest. You yourself go and find some good book. I was good at it, so I did not refer to any book. For Hindi language, I think there is one book by Sriram Lahaus. So you may find it useful. It's good, especially for Haryana, I think. There are passages in Hindi and they have been translated. So it is good. Another question was, kitne ghante padhe? See, all depends on how concentrated you are, what kind of college you have graduated from, and how good your concepts are. I myself used to read 8 hours a day, and generally I did not take any break even on Sundays. So 8 hours must be more than sufficient. If your background is weak, then I think you may do a little more work. If your background is good, then you may walk away with even some less time. Another question was, which section important hai? Dekho, which section important hai? Iska koi broad formula nahi hai. Jo hai, kuch sections hote hain jinka aapko idea hona chahiye that okay, that is there. Ki wo section 10 mein diya hua hai. Bahut zyada usse yaad karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Kuch section hote hain ki ek ek ingredient aapko yaad karna hota hai. Theft mein aapko pata hona chahiye ki kaun si movable property hai. कि मूवेबल प्रॉपर्टी पे अप्लाई होता है, दूसरा ये कि पजेशन में होनी चाहिए, तीसरा ये कि ओनरशिप से मतलब नहीं है थेफ्ट का, इट ओनली कंसर्न विद पजेशन, और पता होना चाहिए कि जो है अपनी प्रॉपर्टी की थेफ्ट हो सकती है. इस टाइप की चीजें थोड़ी सी कुछ सेक्शंस में जरूरी होती हैं. खुद एनालिसिस करना पड़ेगा, कहीं ना कहीं वो आपको कोई लिख के दे भी देगा ना, इट्स नॉट गोना वर्क एक्चुअली. फिर जीके के लिए बहुत से लोगों ने मुझसे पूछा, यूपी जीके की जहां तक सवाल है, देन यू मस्ट गो फॉर घटनाचक्र. There is no shortcut there. You must take its volume on history, geography and other subjects. And you must also take its magazine of current affairs. For UP, they have a very extensive paper on GK and you have to go with Ghatnachakra. Apart from that, for the current affairs of other state, I think Pratyukta Darpan English edition would do a wonderful job. It's a very good magazine. I was continuously referring to it. Even for Delhi's current affairs, it would be more than enough. As far as Delhi's static GK is concerned, I think you may take one book of Lucent or Upkar and read selectively from it. There are some questions like when were the first Asian Games held? They would give you 4 options and then they may ask you who was the first Governor General, who was the last Governor General, such type of things they may ask. Look at previous papers. Moreover, state-wise questions you must prepare. In MP, UP and Haryana, they ask some basic questions from the state. How many districts are there in Haryana? Who was the first governor of Uttar Pradesh? Such type of things. Other question was, coaching notes sufficient? No, I don't think that coaching notes are sufficient. You must prepare something else along with it. I don't think that comprehensive study is needed apart from your notes. But here and there, you must add something to your notes. It would be very useful for you because your task is to find out that how much it left out. In Rahul sir, I think Rahul sir especially tells you that which sections he would not be covering, so that makes your job easy. But do some self study apart from that. I think that's it. One small request, please share this video with the people who don't have taken coaching or did not take coaching. So because my idea is to share with those people only. If you have taken any coaching, then surely you must know all these points. But it may be a great help for the people who did not take coaching. So thank you very much. If you have any questions, you may ask me. I think most of you might know my Facebook account, and you may just comment below. Thank you.